10, 9, 8. Go for main engine start. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
50 years ago, tragedy shook the Soviet space race. A ship manned by three cosmonauts had departed on June 6th of 1971, with the mission of living the first experience of prolonged human life in space and return to tell the story. When they landed, all three were dead. The mission of the Soyuz 11, as the ship was named, consisted in docking with Salyut 1, the first space station in history. Once there, the cosmonauts were supposed to enter, live there for a while, fix anything broken, adjust the instruments and return. Most of it was completed successfully. Then, on June 29, the ship returned to the Earth. When the space capsule was opened, all three cosmonauts were dead. An air escape has asphyxiated them with extraordinary speed and precision. None of them was wearing a space suit, an element that could have saved their lives, because the experiment consisted partly in knowing what will happen with astronauts without protection and extra oxygen. Also, the big space suits will have reduced the crew to 2 people, and the authorities wanted to send 3. The crew of the Soyuz 11 docked automatically with the space station on June 7. They turned on the air system and replaced some fans that were broken. Immediately, they smelled a strong smell of smoke and were recommended to stay in the ship for that night. The next day, the air was normal and the cosmonauts felt at home. They made some maneuvers of orbital correction and oriented the panels of the station towards the sun. On the Earth, the world press was talking about the achievement. On June 29, the men left the space station and got into the ship, beginning the return to the Earth. When closing the hatch, a sensor showed that the seal wasn't airtight, and they were recommended to repeat the operation. After several tries, the alarm stopped. The ship separated from the station and started the descent. It entered the atmosphere, and the parachute was opened. The Soyuz swung elegantly towards the territory of today Kazakhstan. 6 meters over the ground, 2 powerful rockets turned on and made it rest on the earth like a feather. The rescue team started to follow the design procedure. They opened the hatch, hoping to find the 3 men and carry them in helicopter to the glory. But they were all dead. A desperate battle to revive them started. Mouth-to-mouth breathing, cardiac massage, were a useless battery of medical resources in the dry Kazakh land. The astronauts have been dead for half an hour. The small but powerful explosive devices that were detonated in the space to separate the ship from the space station had opened 2 little valves with a diameter of 1 millimeter, designed to never open together. But they did, 6 seconds apart. The precious air inside the Soyuz started escaping, and the agony of the crew began. Till then, everything was going on normally. In the moment of the separation from the space station, the heart rate of the astronauts was normal, about 100 pulses over a minute. The 3 of them quickly noticed the air leak, thanks to the sound that it produced, and their heart rates skyrocketed, reaching about 140. They turned off the radio system, trying to locate the source of the sound. They found it in the valve situated over the seat of Patsáyev. The emergency procedure dictated that, in 20 seconds, the leak had to be controlled, but on the training, it took between 30 and 40 seconds. The delay would have been irrelevant if they had been wearing space suits, but that wasn't the case. Later investigations estimated that 20 seconds after the starting of the leak, the pressure in the ship was so low that the astronauts must have already been unconscious. 50 seconds later, the heart rate of Patsáyev had dropped to 42. At 110 seconds, the hearts of the 3 men stopped. Dobrovolski, Patsáyev, and Volkov were declared national heroes by the Soviet Union and, after a state funeral, were buried in the Kremlin.